While the markets are flat, there are a clutch of names that seem to be doing okay. V-Mart Retail is one such, which is, I mean, while maybe trading negative despite a strong second quarter, but the idea would be to talk about the highlights of the quarter gone by. Joining us on the phone line is Chief Financial Officer Anand Agarwal. Good evening, Mr. Agarwal. Thanks so much for joining in. Sum up the quarter for us, and how has the first month post-GST transition been?
So, thank you so much. I think the quarter went by very well for us. The revenue has grown by 23% for the quarter. The same store sales growth is a positive number at 8%, while in volume terms it is at 13%. The sales per square feet has also increased by around 7%. We have opened 8 new stores in the quarter. So overall, we are looking at a good growth from all directions. The quarter two traditionally is slightly weak as far as the retail sector in India is concerned, but we're quite confident of having a good growth coming throughout the year, and quarter two was also not an exception. So we look forward to having good growth coming in for the rest of the year as well. Coming to the second part of the question, GST transition has went on quite well. So the entire ecosystem of our vendors and the company's ERP and the accounting systems have been very well geared up and are now fully compliant and ready right from the day one. And we see good traction coming in from that front as well. We see a slight dent in the consumer sentiment as far as GST is concerned on the ground level in the Tier 2, Tier 3 towns. But we remain confident on the overall success of the GST mechanism and the contribution that GST will bring in, not just for the company, but for the entire country.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Agarwal, you have brought down your finance cost by 33%. Do you see further scope? Do you have further plans of reducing it?
We do have plans. In fact, finance cost is reducing on the back of cash that is being generated from the business. So we are less reliant on borrowings. In fact, we were almost a debt-free company. We are almost a debt-free company. So there's very little amount of debt that we take on only to cater to seasonal requirements. But as we continue to remain profitable and continue to generate cash, we will probably have more funds to spare and therefore less reliance on debt going forward as well. So finance costs should continue to keep coming down.
Hmm. Mr. Agarwal, could you tell us what were the inventory days in the second quarter compared to the first quarter?
So inventory days were slightly higher at 96 if I compare it to the last quarter, which was 75 days. But that is traditionally on account of stocking up for the busy winter season and the Diwali season. So as at end of September, we closed the quarter at 96. Which is much healthy if I compare to last year of 103 days.
Okay, and in the second half, are you saying you will maintain these inventory days or you will look to at least bring it down?
No, we will continuously endeavor to bring it down, and we are quite confident that it should also come down. So as I mentioned, this slightly stocking up is purely on account of the upcoming winter season and the festival period. As in the past, this should see a southward trend in by the end of Q3 and also in Q4.
Hmm. Just a last question from my side. The average selling price for the quarter for your apparel segment has actually fallen marginally. Just want to check, is there any reason for same, and what would the guidance be for the second half?
So the ASP or the average selling price has been marginally down, but that is as part of a very well thought out strategy where we are concentrating on increasing our volume-led growth as we are entering the slightly lower segment of the ecosystem, which is Tier 3 and Tier 4 towns, where we are intending to generate more demand through volume-led growth rather than value-led growth. So for the rest of the year, I think the guidance, while we do not issue a real guidance, but in terms of growth, I think we remain confident that we should be able to maintain the same store sales growth of around 8 to 10% and the overall growth of between 15 to 20%.